أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما. اللهم إني أسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا. آمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. So first of all, alhamdulillah, I feel different emotions, but really feel thankful that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me the opportunity and the strength to be able to complete it, you know, the last session of teaching today. So whenever I'm starting any new course or I'm making a commitment, I always have this fear that I'm making the commitment whether I'll be able to fulfill it or not. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so merciful that He makes it possible. So alhamdulillah for it. Okay, so lafif basically, like we say in Urdu also, lifafa. So what does a lifafa do? It enveloped around something. You put something in it and then it is all around it. So that is what exactly is the root words of lafif. Means to envelop. And why lafif is called lafif? Because obviously the word is enveloped with the weak letters. And then we have two types of lafif. We know them, but we'll quickly review that. First is the lafif mafruq. So mafruq is the ism maf'ul from the root words faraqa. And farq, we know it means distance. So when the first root, I haven't written actually, the first and third root. R vowels. Okay, so the combination of it is like the first, when first root is a vowel, it's a mithal. And then when the last root is a vowel, it's a naqis. So lafife mafruq is basically mithal plus naqis. And that will give us the lafife mafruq. Okay. The lafife mafruq comes only in three babs. So from Bab Daraba, Bab Hasiba, and Bab Samia. Now, how does it act in these Babs? So basically, in Bab Daraba, it's Waqa and Yaqi. So what rules do you see are being applied here? Meanwhile, I'll see that who all have. I was asking a question that what are the rules that we see are being applied. Yeah. You cannot see my screen. Sister, do you see my screen?
Yes, I can see it, Samia.
Okay, someone is saying that. Sister Shima is saying that she cannot see the screen.
I can see it also, Beta.
Okay. Alhamdulillah, Sister Samia, I can see now.
Okay. I just saw the messages. And
yeah, initially I wasn't able to see, but now Alhamdulillah, I can see and hear.
Okay, so I was asking, Alhamdulillah. So I was asking, when it is Waqa and Yaqi, what rules we see that are being applied here? So waqa, the ending is like, and also yaqi. So the ending is like what? The ending is like the naqis. And also we see that in the present tense, yaqi, the waw is being dropped. So why do you think the vow is being dropped? What rule is that? Pending is like nafis. And why is the vow being dropped? Someone will answer, that will make it easy for us. The vow is dropped because it is following the misal rules. Va'ada ya'idu, we did it, but obviously it's been a while. So in some of the babs of misal, what happens, the vow is being dropped, not in all the babs. So when we have waqa yaqi, are we able to recognize which bab it is? Looking at the haraka on the middle root. Okay, now if everyone is going to be quiet, how will we have the session? It doesn't matter. Now I'm not going to ask.
Better, I can't say. That's why I'm quiet. I can't figure it out.
Okay, but look at the haraka on the middle root, a fatha and a kasra. So which bab is it going to be? Past tense has a fatha, and the present tense has a kasra. So which bab?
Daraba.
It's going to be yes.
Daraba yadribu. Okay, yeah. Yes. Daraba yadribu.
Daraba yadribu. So this is why I haven't written. Everyone can recognize. It's not so difficult. It's bab daraba. Alhamdulillah, Noshaba aunty, I'm so proud of you.
Jazakallah beta.
Okay. So the masdar, we get it from the dictionary. Wiqayatan. And then the ismul fa'il is exactly on the pattern of naqis. We are not getting into the irregularity rules because it is exactly following all the rules of the naqis. So hadin or da'in, on the same pattern, we have the ismul fa'il waqin. Okay, the majhool is going to be guqiya. No. Then yuqa. Wiqayatan fahuwa mawqiyun mahdiyun, on the pattern, because the ending is having a ya, it is waw qaf ya are the root words. So on the pattern of mahdiyun, it's mawqiyun. Okay, al amru minhu, we get al amru minhu qi wa nahi anhu la taqi wa zarfu minhu mawqan wa alatu minhu miqatun. Okay, do we understand how do we get the amr qi? So what is the present tense? The present tense is yaqi. So from yaqi we get into the anta form. What is going to be the anta form? From waqi, the anta form will be
taqi.
Yes, taqi. The vowel is dropped, and then in the same way just change the into a ta, so we get taqi. Now what do we have to do? We have to make it madzoom. So how do we make the because the ending is naqis, so we will make it madzoom the way we make the naqis madzoom. So what do we get? Drop the vowel and we get
taqi.
Taqi. Now because it is the amr, so we have to drop the ta also. So what do we get? Now we get qi. Is there a need to add the hamza-i wasli? Are we going to add any hamza-i wasli here?
No,
because we are able to pronounce it. Qi, we can pronounce it. We only add a hamza-i wasli when the first letter in the word is a sakin letter, and then we are not able to pronounce it, hence we need that hamza-i wasli. But here we see that qi, we don't have any problem in pronouncing it, so we get it al-amru minhu qi, and that is the command for it. Wa nahi anhu, in the same way La taqi. So this is the same way. What do we do? From yaqi, we get into taqi and then we make it majzoom. So we get la taqi. Is it clear to everyone? It is simple.
Yes, clear.
Ji beta.
Okay. Okay, alhamdulillah. So this is like the first bab for today. Then we have the bab hasiba. So the verb we will do in it in waw lam ya. So wala, yali. In the same way, what is happening? Sorry, not wala, waliya, because it's hasiba. So waliya and yali, you actually becomes yali. Again, because what rules are we applying here? We are applying the rules of misal. And we are applying the rules of naqis here. Okay, these two rules we are applying here. So the ending is having the naqis ending. And then the waw in the present tense is dropped because of the misal rule. So wala yali wilayatan is the masdar from the dictionary. Fahuwa walin. Da'in on the same weight is walin. The passive is going to be wuliya, yula in the majhul, the waw will come back. So yula wilayatan fahuwa mawliyun. Mahdiyun mawliyun. Okay, in the same way we get the amar alamru minhu li. Wa nahi anhu la tali. Do we all get understand now how do we get this amar alamru minhu li? Or anyone is confused, then I will explain. So from tali, from yali, we get the anta form tali. Make it majzoom and we get tali. Drop the ta and what do we get? We just get li. Alamru minhu li. Wa nahi anhu la tali. Someone has to speak, just one person out of, you know, we have a number of participants. Ismail somehow is not able to join in. And I see that also Sister Sara is not able to join. So some sister has to speak, either Aisha Api or Sister Nutrat or Sister Shima, one of you must speak out. Okay, so this is the two babs, and in what happens, we see that in both these babs, we are following the naqis rules and we are following the misal rules as well. There is the third bab, which is the hasiba bab. No, hasiba bab we have done. Okay, the sami'a bab. In the sami'a bab, it is going to be a little different, this bab. Why this bab is going to different? Going to be different because anyone remembers what actually happens in the bab sami'a in the misal? In the misal, in bab sami'a, we do not drop the waw. So the same thing we see here. So what is going to happen here that we will only follow the, we are not going to follow the misal rules because misal rules are not being applied on bab sami'a. Rather, what we will do, so now it is going to be a little further easier for us because here we will only apply the naqis rules. Okay. So that's why wajiya sami'a and yasma'u yauja. So the waw is there. Let us highlight it so that we remember that. Here we are not applying the mithal. Wajian is the masdar and ismul fa'il is the same thadin or da'in wajin. Wujiya, yuja, wajian and ismul maf'ul is mawjiyun. Mahdiyun, mawjiyun. Al amru minhu, for it is going to be UG. This summer, let me explain. Okay. And then I will tell you what happens in this summer. So from Yauja, what is going to be the anta form?
Tauja?
Okay. Yes, alhamdulillah. Thank you, auntie. It's going to be Tauja. Okay, from Tauja, how we make it Okay, make it Majzoom. How do we make it Majzoom?
Tauja and drop the ending.
Yeah.
Yes, so what do we get?
Tauja.
Tauja.
Tauja, yes. Drop the ya from the there and from the ending, and then we get Tauja. And then drop the ta. So if you drop the ta, what happens that vowel doesn't have a haraka on it. So we will not be able to pronounce it. Hence we need the hamzai wasli. Now what should be the haraka on hamzai wasli?
Kasra.
Kasra. Now what happens, the kasra and the vowel are not compatible, right? So what should we do? We should make it, we cannot say AUG. I just write it so that we all understand, and then I'm going to change it for us.
Changes so, to ya?
It changes into a ya. So it becomes EG. So this is how we get it, this. Sorry, you. So Amar is going to be Ija, and in the same way, what is going to be the Nahi? La.
La Tauji.
La. La Tauja. No, no, no.
La Tauja.
The ta is a fatha sister, Nudirat. Okay, and when we write the fatha and the vowel together, we can pronounce it. So this is going to remain as it is. La Tauja. This is going to change because the vowel and the kasra are not compatible. Hence, we have to make them compatible. So al amru minhu ija. Wa nahi anhu la. Tauja. When we make, look at this siga, when we make it majzoom, what do we get? We get tauja. The fatha and the vowel, we can pronounce it, so it, the nahi will remain la tauja. Is it clear?
Yes, alhamdulillah. Yes.
So again, I will say alamru minhu ija wa nahi anhu la tauja, and the zarf is the same, maujan. So we can highlight it that it, this is actually a little different family than the rest of the two families we did. Because only we are applying the naqis rules and we are not applying the mithal. Okay, that's what it is. That's all for the makruq and then makroon. So again, makroon, what is this siga? Makroon, what siga is it?
You mean the root words, beta?
No, the word, what? The root words. Okay, khala, you can tell the root words.
Qaran?
Yes, qafranun, okay. But what siga is it?
Oh, I see what you're saying, yeah. Is it about five maf'ul?
Maf'ul, similarly, it is the pattern of maf'ul. So one being closed, qarn means closed. So maqroon means one being closed. Yes, happy. Right. So now this, the lafife maqroon is basically a combination of the ajwaf and naqis. And that will give us the lafife mafrooq. So means what is going to happen here, we will have the second and the third root. Second and third root of vowels. Okay, so this is all for the lafife mafrooq and then lafife maqroon. Okay, so it is easy again. What is happening? That this only comes in the two babs, bab daraba and bab sami'a. Now, this is a much easier way of doing it, because what is going to happen? It is only going to follow naqis rules. It only follows the naqis rules. We don't have to worry much about the ajwaf rules. So this is tawa yaqwi. Which bab do you think it is?
Daraba.
Again, this is bab daraba, yes. Looking at the root, middle root haraka. So this is bab daraba. Tawa yaqwi. Payan fahua pawin. It's following the naqis rules. Then tuviya yutwa payan fahua matwiyun. Only this yeva matwiyun. Mahdiyun. On the pattern the same way. Mahdiyun. Okay. Al-amru minhu itwi wa nahi anhu la tatwi wa zarfu minhu matwan wa alatu minhu mitwatun. So this amar is simple. From yatwi we make it tatwi. From tatwi what do we get? Drop the ya. So tatwi becomes tatwi, and then drop the ya, the ta from here, and because ta has a sukoon on it, so we need a hamza-i wasli, and the hamza-i wasli will take a kasra, so we get al-amru minhu itwi, and similarly when nahi anhu la tatwi. Is it clear to everyone, or is there a confusion in the amar?
Alhamdulillah, beta.
Okay, just a minute, there's someone at the door, so I have to go and open. There's no one in the home except me, so just give me 2 minutes. So then the next bab is bab samia raviya yarwa rayyan fahuwa rabin. Then ruviya yurwa rayyan fahuwa marviyun. Al amru minhu irwa wa nahi anhu la tarwa wa zarfu minhu marwan. So this is the second family, bab samia, from lafife maqroon. if there is a question regarding it, then you can ask. Otherwise, we'll quickly move on to the Mazid Fihi families. So actually, let us quickly recap that what is happening. We see that in the Lafife Mafrooq, we have three babs, bab Daraba, bab Hasiba, and bab Samia. So two babs, bab Daraba, will have the naqis and the misal rules. So when we say the misal rules only, it is going to affect one of the sigas, that is the present tense, and no effect on any other siga. Okay, and then we have the next bab, which is bab Hasiba. In bab Hasiba also, we will have the misal and the naqis rule. So naqis rule will apply throughout, but the misal rule will only be applied on the present tense. The vowel will be dropped. But this bab, the bab Samia, it is different. What happens in bab Samia, that it will only have the naqis rule being applied on it, and we will not apply the misal rule, because the misal rule we cannot apply on the bab Samia. That is all about Lafife Mafrooq. In Lafife Maqroon, it is easy because it is going to act exactly like the naqis. Although we see it's going to be the ajwaf, but actually ajwaf doesn't do any of its work. So it is just going to act like a naqis. So it is simple for us. We have been practicing naqis for quite a number of sessions. Now what happens also in all the Mazid Fihi families, whether it is the Lafife Mafrooq or it is the Lafife Maqroon, all the Mazid Fihi families will act exactly like naqis. They will only take the naqis rules on them. So it is easy. We will just do two families, and then will be enough for us to understand that, okay, how it works. So this is waw, ha, ya are the root words, and it is family 4. Okay, so when we put it in the family 4, what do we get? Awha, yuhi, ihaan, fahuwa, muhin. Uhiya, yuha, ihaan, fahuwa, muhan. Al amru minhu, awhi. Because this is family 4, so obviously this hamza qatai is there in the pattern of Amr. La tuhi wa zarfu minhu muhan. So we see that this, the throughout the sarf saghir is exactly like the sarf saghir of a naqis word. The lafif really don't have any effect on the sarf saghir. And then we will see another example of the lafife maqroon. Seen, waw, ya are the root words, and this is family 3. So sa wa, yusa vi, siva an, wa musawatan, sorry, musawatan, fahuwa musabin. Suviya, yusa wa, siva an, wa musawatan, fahuwa musaban. Al amru minhu sawi wa nahyu anhu la tusawi wa zarfu minhu musawan. So is it clear, both things, how the mazid fihi will act, sorry, how the lafif is going to act in the mazid fihi families? It is going to act exactly like the naqis, and also the sarf kabir are going to be the same, so we don't really have to worry much about it. If we have a good practice of the naqis, obviously we will be able to do the lafif well. Okay, if there is a question someone needs to ask, then inshallah you can ask. Okay, inshallah then. Because this is the last session, so let us talk about this word. So the Surah Baqarah starts with Alif Lam Mim, Dhalikal Kitabu La Rayba Fihi Hudan Lil Muttaqin. So what do we understand with the word Muttaqin? Who are Muttaqin? If someone wants to unmute, then you can please unmute Sister Nukrat if you can. Doesn't matter even if Ibrahim is participating. Let him.
Assalamu alaikum.
what do we understand by taqwa? Okay, let's say what do we understand by taqwa, and then we'll talk about what is not taqwa.
It's the consciousness of Allah.
Yes, the consciousness of Allah. What else do we understand?
I just understand it as being mindful, which is the same thing as I think Shima said.
Mindful, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching. Who else wants to add up? Basically, if you look at the literal meaning, if we take waw kafya, so waw kafya basically means to protect. Bachna. So when it comes, so this is basically babi, iftial, family 8. Ittaqa yattaqi ittaqa'an fahuwa muttaqin. So taqwa basically means to avoid all sins, whether they are small sins or they are greater sins, to avoid them, to protect yourself from the sins, basically it is taqwa. What happens, I've seen in Pakistan, and I really feel, I really feel strange about it, because what people say is, and even in the translations, and if you ask even people who consider themselves knowledgeable, if you ask them what is the meaning, who is a muttaqi? So they will say the one who fears, jo darta hai. Muttaqi, wo hai jo darta hai. So basically, I just, one of the hidden meanings of a muttaqi, or your darna is one of the hidden meanings, but it is not the basic meanings. And some people also think that a pious person or a person who is doing good deeds is a muttaqi person, but rather it is more, it's not about doing the good deeds, it's more about not doing the bad deeds. So that is what taqwa is. And then Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he asked Ubay bin Ka'b, then what do you think taqwa is? So he radiallahu ta'ala anha said that, how will you walk on a path which is filled with the thorny bushes? So Hazrat Umar, he replied that I'm going to protect myself and I'm going to protect my clothes. So this, he said that this is taqwa, like to protect yourself, to save yourself. Like when you're walking on a thorny path, so you'll protect yourself so that you are not being harmed by those bushes, the thorns, and you're not even being, your clothes are not even being harmed. So you're going to be very conscious. So that is what taqwa is. So it's really important to understand what is the deeper meaning of taqwa. So muttaqeen are the people who save themselves from these major sins and minor sins. Like, you do not consider any sin to be a small sin, but just know that a sin is a sin and you protect yourself from it.
So protect oneself from all sins.
Yes, to protect yourself from all sort of sins. So this is exactly what Hasan Basri Rahimullah, he said, that when you have something about which you are doubtful, it's not even about the sin, a sinful thing, but you come across something, an act, and you're doubtful about it, and you leave that act. So that is going to lead towards developing the strength of your taqwa. Mushtaba cheezon ko chhod dena. You have a doubt about it. You're not sure whether it is halal or haram. So you leave it, and then you'll be able to strengthen your taqwa. And also very beautiful saying, any sister wants to add, then she can add. Someone was probably saying something. Okay, then I will add. This is a very beautiful Arabic saying, and it is, these are the words of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he said that at-taqwa yal khawfu min al-jaleel, that you have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At-taqwa hiya al-khawfu min al-jaleel. Wal-amalu bit-tanzeel, that you act upon tanzeel. What is the meaning of tanzeel here? Quran and Sunnah. So you one of the names of Quran is Tanzeel. We know it. So you act upon Quran. Wal amalu bit Tanzeel. It's two things. And the third thing he said about, it's wal qina'atu bil qaleel. That what little you have, you are not patient upon it, but you are just happy upon it. You do not need more of the worldly material things. So wal qina'atu bil qaleel. Being happy on little material things of this world. And then the fourth thing is wal isti'dadu li yawmi rahil. Yawmi rahil is the day when you set off on a journey. So al isti'dadu, you prepare for the day when you will set off for the journey, means you prepare for your death. So these are the four things. If we have those things, like, or if we try to develop them, then it's going to lead towards strengthening the taqwa we have in our hearts. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us the people of taqwa.
Samia, can you share this saying of Hazrat Ali in the group?
Yes, so I wanted to, but I was short of time, so no, I couldn't type.
Whenever you have time, you can share the picture of your notes, like just this saying, so we can add up in the notes.
Okay, inshallah.
Exactly.
It's very beautiful. I really love it. So I have it.
Yeah, it's beautiful. And the way he said it, that is beautiful. Like
exactly, the rhythm. Okay, alhamdulillah. So this is what we have to talk about, because it was the last session, so I want to make it, you know, a little special and leave an impact, you know, on each one of us. And we become, you know, we try to become the people of taqwa. At least we all need to make a harder effort towards becoming the muttaqin. Okay, and then we have to talk about this surah. So alhamdulillah, I was going through it and I thought, let us talk about the surah Asr. What happens, I know that most of us already have gone through this surah Asr so many times, but obviously it is like saying that the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the reminder benefits the believer. So for me, I need the reminder first of all, and then obviously the rest of you also need a reminder. So what is the word, lafif word we see in it? Do we see any lafif word in Surah Asr?
Bete, innal insana lafi. Lafi should be.
No, lam is the lam, it's taqeed, and fi is the harfijar.
Harfijar, yes.
Maybe someone can type in it.
Tawasi.
Yes, it is. It is tawasi. So waw, swad, ya are the root words. And which bab it is?
Family six,
yes. So what is it going to be in family six? Waw, swad, ya, if we put it in family six, what do we get?
Sorry, Mr. Samia, please repeat your question.
What is the surf we will get when we put waw swadhyaya in family six?
This is mazi, right? No, this is amar, right?
No.
This is mazi.
Looking at the previous, you see, the amar and the mazi are going to be exactly the same. So when we look at amanu and amilu, so again, tawasau will be what? Yeah. It will be mazi for?
Yeah.
It will be mazi for whom?
Home version, right?
Home version, yes. Mazi for the home version. So anyone wants to do the surf sagir for it?
Tawasa,
right?
Yatawasau.
No, yatawasa, because this is family six. Tawasa, yatawasa.
So
the masdar will be tawasan.
Tawasiyan.
Tawasiyan.
Fahuwa mutawasin.
Tawasin.
Yes. Next, passive will be
tuwisa.
Tuwusiya. Tuwusiya. Yutawasa. Tawasiyan. And its maful will be mutawasan. Okay, I will share it. I knew it's going to be a little difficult, so here it is. Tawasa, yatawasa, tawasiyan, fahuwa mutawasin. It's exactly like the naqis. Tuwusiya, yutawasa, tawasiyan, fahuwa mutawasan. Alamru minhu tawasa. What is the meaning of Vav Swadhyaya in family 6? Anyone knows?
Ek dusre ko nasihat karna.
Right. And this is the, when it comes in family 6, basically it means to remind each other and give each other an advice, and this advice has to be an important advice, very important, and advice that actually affect the whole of your life. So that is what Vav Swadhyaya in family 6 means.
Sami, you once told that there are books written by the scholars on the rhetorical benefits of the families. Have you read those books, like all those books? Have you read?
No, subhanallah, no. I've just started my journey.
Okay, mashallah, inshallah, one day you will. So if you if you know any name of that in book, and you can share with us, you know.
Okay, inshallah. I really don't know as book really, but I will find out and I will share.
Inshallah.
I just have those notes that I've once shared with you by Ustad Noman and the rest of the TAs. So
mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what we have, right? But the students usually they ask that, okay, this on this word this is not applicable, so what is happening here?
I will, inshallah, what I will do, I will ask one of my teachers, so probably they will be able to help out.
Okay, jazakallah.
In the madrasa, so
inshallah.
Okay, so yes, so let us talk about this surah a bit. Anyone wants to talk about it, then you can talk about it, and then I will add up to it. And if no one wants to say anything, then inshallah, I will. Okay. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking oath, and he is taking oath while us we. This is an oath. And there are different opinions about what is the meaning of Al-Asr or what is the meaning of Al-Asr. But the most common opinion is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking the oath by the time which is running very quickly. It's just slipping out of our hands. So he's taking oath of that time. And then why is it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take oaths in Quran? Because whenever the subject matter which is coming is extremely important, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to pay, obviously he wants us to pay attention on everything that is in Quran, but when he wants us to be extra attentive towards what is about to come, then he subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath. So here he has taken an oath. And then look at the usloob of this ayah, inna linsana lafi khusr. So first of all, the emphasis is coming, lots and lots of emphasis, because there is this qasam, which is indicating obviously what is coming is going to be very important, wants us to take an action. And again, we see that inna is the harfi taqid, inna is for emphasis. So inna, this is a jumla ismiya. Inna linsana lafi khusr is a jumla ismiya. So the inna is actually acting upon the mubtada, and even we see on the khabar, fi khusrin is the khabar, and we again see the lam-e-taqeed on it. So also, so much of the emphasis is being made on the sentence where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that certainly without a doubt, each and every human being is in a loss. And khusr is, what kind of a loss is khusr? Khusr is kind of a loss that you will never be able to make up for it. Like sometimes people face a loss in their business, but then after a while they are able to make up for it. Or sometimes what happens, especially this happens in Pakistan, that someone has given an exam and the person failed in the exam, but then this person is able to give a supplementary exam and do well in it and able to pass and go to the next standard or the next level. Or if it is in university that you have failed a subject, then you'll be able to retake the subject. But the khusr is a kind of a loss that you will not be able to make up for that loss. It is a loss for eternity. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that each and every human being is in eternal loss. And then he's making exception. So what is the exception? Those that these are the people who will not be in loss. So who are these people? The ones who, alladhina amanu, who believe, wa amilu salihat, and they do the righteous deeds, and they advise each other bilhaqi, towards the truth, and they advise each other towards the sabr or patience. So the all, let us write it, number one. It is going to be the people who believe. Then, what is the next thing they do? They do righteous deeds. Then number three is they advise each other. Towards the truth. And the fourth thing is that they advise each other towards patience. So these are the four things. So believe, we all know that what it is believing. What do we understand when we say the one, the people who believe? Means they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They believe in the prophets. And they believe in the, yes, they believe in the last day. So these are the three main components of belief, or we can say the imaniyate thalatha, the three beliefs. So believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then believing in the prophets, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent the prophets. Why he sent them? So that the prophets can guide us and tell us what is right and what is wrong. And then believing in the last day, that obviously there is going to be a last day when we will be answerable for whatever we have done in this world. So the dunya is darul amal. Whatever we will do in this darul amal, then we will find the recompensation on the day, the last day, or the day of judgment, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge us for what we have done. So this is what belief is. Then the second thing is they do righteous deeds. So we all actually know what are righteous deeds. Do the good things that we, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Quran has told us to do, and what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the hadith and through his sunnah has taught us to do. So what happens is that most of us, all the Muslims, you know, including myself, so we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the imaniyat salasa, and we do the righteous deeds. You know, we make sure that we are praying on time, how we make sure that we are fasting, and we do charity as much as we can, and other good deeds also. So number one and number two, we follow. But then what about number three and number four? What is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying? Illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat wa tawasaw bilhaqi Vadhavasau Visavri means all the four components are important. We cannot leave one and take one. It's not pick and choose thing. So all four things must be in our practice in order that we are able to save ourselves from the eternal loss. So now let us see what is the third thing. It is that they advise each other towards the truth, tawasi bil haq. And what is this? Tawasi bil haq means? Amar bil ma'roof and nahi anil munkar. So you are telling the other person to do good deeds. So first of all, you do it yourself, which is number two. Now you are concerned about other people and you tell the other person, okay, that you have to do good deeds. And if you see the other person from doing something evil or with another person breaking the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you also stop the person. So what happens that some of us will tell, okay, this is right and this is wrong. But we do, when we see someone sinning, we just say that it is the person's own affair. Let us not get into his personal affair. Isn't it? Generally, we have this understanding that let the person do what he wants to do, and the religion is the person's own affair. So why should we get into the person's religion? So actually, when it is tawasi bil haq, you have to convey what is right, and you also have to convey what is wrong. And obviously, you have to do it with hikmah, not in a way that the other person will feel bad about it, or you get into a fight with the other person, or you humiliate someone. We don't have to judge anyone. We just have to convey the message.
Samia?
Ji, auntie.
Yeah. But, you know, the advice, I mean, do we just give it once and then leave it? Or is it just constant advice you keep giving a person?
It depends upon the relationship you have with the person, auntie. If it is a family member, then you'll see whenever it's possible. I know that people get irritated if they don't want to listen to constant reminders, but we have to give them reminders. Like, yes. If not every day, maybe it depends like how the other person is. And sometimes not through the direct words, through the indirect words.
Jazakallah.
Just a minute, let me see, someone is at the door, so I'll come back. There's no one at home, it's just me. So if someone's coming at the door, I have to go and check. Okay, so the example I will give you about the tawasi bil haq, and especially the nahi anil munkar, why is it important and what is the proof that we find of nahi anil munkar from Quran? So two incidents we have. First of all, the people of Sabt. Do we know about the people of Sabt? The hafte wale log.
Yes,
we have the mention of them in a little mention in the Surah Baqarah, and then a detailed mention about them in Surah Araf. So what happens that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is said that these were the people around the time of Hazrat Dawud alayhi salam. They were among the Bani Israel. So what happened that they used to live around, close to a river, and mainly they used to fish, and the fishing was their main source of income for that community. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested them, and sab basically means Saturday, and sab basically, the meaning, literal meaning of sab is to stop or to cease. So it was the command of from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the Bani Israel that you have to stop everything, every worldly thing on a Saturday, and you will just only worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested them, it's that on the Saturday, they used to have so much fish coming that even the fish used to come out of water. And the rest of the days, the rest of the 6 days, when it wasn't a Saturday, then what happened? What happened? The fish never used to come. Like, there hardly was any fish. They were not able to catch enough fish in the remaining 6 days. So what they do is that they make some channels or canals, some ways. There is a difference of opinion. We don't have it how they do it. But somehow they make the way that they used to withhold the fish on a Saturday and then go and get it on the next day, Sunday. So what happened that these people, the community was actually divided into three groups. So what, the first group was the one who was doing this sin by catching the fish, making a way out to catch the fish. They were not doing it directly, but they were doing it indirectly. The next group of people were the ones who were just letting them do what they want to, not stopping them from doing it. And then the third group of people were the ones who actually kept reminding them, giving them nasiha that don't do it. You are sinning. You are breaking the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then what it mentions in Surah Araf that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved the ones who were doing the tawasi, who were reminding the other people not to do, not to sin. Whereas the rest of the two people, what happened to them, like as Aisha Api said, that they were made into humiliated apes. Khiradatan qasirin. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them into apes. So this is a big proof from Quran that, you know, stopping the other person from wrong is also very important. We should do it, but we should be mindful, we should be tactful, but do it in a way. Sometimes directly, sometimes indirectly. And also this, when Hazrat Musa alayhi salam went on the Kohe tour for 30 days initially and then added up another 10 days, 40 days. So Bani Israel thought that, okay, Musa is lost. Now we need another leader. And they made Samri the leader. And Samri, what he did, he made a calf and told them to worship it. He said that Musa alayhi salam went to speak to his Lord, but his Lord is here, like the calf that he made. So the people, some of them, again, these people were divided into three groups. So a group of them started worshiping the calf, as Samri told them to do. Then there was another group of people who were not stopping them from what they were doing. And similarly, the third group of people who were stopping them. So what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished the people who were worshipping the calf. And what was the punishment? The punishment was that from the same, because there was 12 tribes, we know, of Bani Israel, the 12 sons of Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the second group who were not telling them to stop worshipping the calf, their way of tawbah or repentance was to kill from their own tribe the people who were worshipping. So again, this is another incident from the Quran. And obviously, how difficult it is to kill the person who is a relative, isn't it? It's easier to fight or to kill an unknown person or a person from another community. But it is very difficult for you to kill your own people from your own family. So these are the two incidents from Quran. And the last thing, what it is? They advise each other towards patience. What do we know? What is patience? We'll talk about patience a bit and then inshallah. What is patience? What is sabr or patience? What do we understand by sabr? One of the meanings is, like I said, patience. What else do we understand? Sabr.
Bitte, I think it's patience when you are sad and patience when you are happy.
Okay. All right. It's good enough. Anyone else? Sister Shima, you want to say something?
अल्लाह की रजा में राजी होना.
ओके मे बी वन ऑफ द वेज ऑफ पुटिंग इट लाइक दिस
कंट्रोल योर इमोशंस.
सो यस टू कंट्रोल योर इमोशंस एंड इट आल्सो मींस टू बी स्टेडफास्ट. सो बी स्टेडफास्ट बेसिकली देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ सबर. What most of us like Auntie Nushaba said, Allah ki raza mein razi hona, that is one type of patience. And generally when we talk about sabr, so that is what we think about. But then there is another type of sabr as well. Anyone knows about it? So first sabr is sabr ala ta'a, to be patient and steadfast when in obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ala du'a means in obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, so what is going to be the example of this? Like waking up for fajr in winters, like it's very difficult. We are in the cozy bed and then waking up in for fajr, it is very difficult. Or another example of it can be that for you people in the West, when the fasting is so long, you have to fast for 19 to 20 hours in the summer. Most of the sisters or the brothers are working, but still they fast. Why they do it? For the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you are steadfast in doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded to do. So this is the first type of sabr. Okay, is it clear?
I think once Ustad Norman also said that sabr is not when you withstand the oppression. When you withstand oppression, it's not sabr.
To be patient in your situation and to be steadfast.
But just withstanding all the oppression, if anybody does oppresses you, just controlling that, that is not sabr. I think he said in some lectures, so I'm not sure exactly, but...
That is one aspect of sabr, we can say, and that is not the entire picture of sabr.
Yeah.
Okay. And then it's going to be patient and steadfast against sinning. Like, you see something, it's very attractive. You want to do it, but then you remember, okay, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has stopped us from doing it. So you control yourself from doing it and you don't do that sin. That is another, the second type of sabr. Maybe something which is very tasty, everyone is saying it's very tasty, but it's not halal. So you stop yourself from eating it. So being patient and steadfast against sinning is the second type. And then we have a third type. Okay, so in Arabic we will say it is sabr anil ma'asi. Ma'asi is sinning. Ma'asiyat. And the third type of sabr, it is sabr alal masa'ib. So what is al masa'ib? Being patient upon
calamity of musibah.
Hardship?
Yes. Upon calamity. Any calamity has touched you? You lost something? Losing something or a loved one? That can be the biggest calamity in one's life. So when you lose someone or you have a big loss in your life, you just remind yourself that this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I have to be patient upon it. Why I have to be patient upon it? Because I seek my reward when I meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are the three types of patience. So this is like, again, let us go back and see that all these four, they say, Dr. Istar, he say, lawazim-e nijat. These are the four compulsory components. All four of them should be, you know, in our practice if you want to succeed in this life. And if we just pick and choose and we say, okay, I already believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I do righteous deeds, and I advise people around me about the truth, and doesn't matter. I can leave number four. It's not so important to do tawasi bis sabr. So that is, you know, still what is happening. These are the compulsory subject. And when you fail in the compulsory subject in any grades, means you failed overall. So this is what it is. All four of them are important. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us the ones, you know, who have all these four qualities. We try to remind others also. So a very small surah, but it's very in me. Okay, so alhamdulillah, this is all for today. Although I wanted to, but somehow I missed adding the dua. And the dua, we just said that keep it simple for today. So Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina azaban. I will just talk about this. We'll have this. I will add up in the notes. We all know it, but just having a dua from the Lafif. So watch this. Qina azaban nar. Let us give the dua for it. And then Qina. What is Qina? What are the root words? And then what is this dua?
Waqaf ya is waqi.
Yes, waqa yaqeen. What is this?
Samia, how long is the class?
It's just ending.
Okay.
That's it. So this is the Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qi is the amr, and then na is the mafubi, and save us from the punishment of the hellfire. So alhamdulillah, jazakumullah khair everyone for joining me. I really miss Sister Sara. I don't know why she wasn't there. She hasn't even sent me a message. But inshallah, if you have to say something, inshallah, you can say it after I stop.
Samia, what's our next project? That's my question.